They say her afro is still not as big as her heart. Nneka has been dubbed as Africa's sensational hip-hop and soul singer and songwriter. The half-Nigerian, half-German talent is on a mission to revolutionize the current state of Africa through music. And after two successful albums, she's not too far from her mission. Her passion is her music, and her music is her power. Nneka has been caught on the spot with Face2face Africa.
Well, I never really made up my mind. And it was never really something that I pursued as a child. Or I never really had dreams of becoming a musician or all that. What happened was that, I always had the passion for writing and expressing myself through melody. You know, if you're standing on the stage, a lot of people look up to you, and especially the youths. So you must have something to say. I'm kind of a vessel that is being used to speak to a masses. Why feed the world with mass stupidity of superficial things, you know? So it's better to be more conscious of your environment and, you know, express those issues. So that is why I talk a lot about political issues. I talk about corruption. I talk about the Niger Delta, where I come from. You know, all these topics, themes concern me because I personally am connected to those topics. Well, as a child, you listen, especially if you grew up in Nigeria, you listen to a lot of traditional music, you listen to gospel, especially gospel that comes from outside Africa. And then, of course, other international artists. Nigerians like flashy stuff that comes from outside. Whitney Houston, Boyz II Men, Mariah Carey, everybody knows every song of these people. But all that had, of course, an influence on me, but I picked out the artists I liked. I like Bob Marley, I love Fela. I began to like when I understood what he was talking about. Initially, we thought it was a crazy man that smokes too much of weed. But then eventually, I understood his intention and his passion. And I've learned a lot from Fela. Yeah. It was never my intention to step out of Africa. There were some circumstances that occurred, and I had to get out. For the first time, I had to face the other half of me, which I then eventually got to know. I was in Germany for about 5-6 years. I did all sorts of jobs, learned the language, studied archaeology and anthropology, you know, got to know the record company. They gave me the opportunity to express myself as a musician, and of course also get to know myself as a person, and also learn more about Africa, because it almost seemed as if I had to get out to understand, you know, to see Africa, you know, from to understand what was happening within Africa, you know. It's good to get out, you know. So I think all that, the movement, stepping out of Nigeria, getting to know myself better, having the time to know myself, because when I was in Nigeria, I didn't really have that space, the opportunity, the financial access to know, hello, excuse me, you want to be a singer? No, that's not happening, you know. So all the moving out of Nigeria for a while definitely helped me understand who I am, who I want to be, who I think I am and I'm not. More of my music, my passion, and I eventually moved back to Nigeria after 6 years. Having to live in a totally different community, mentality, you know, all that, and then of course experiencing racism, prejudice at the university, you know, because you are mixed, black more or less, you know, made me more aware of my heritage. And that's where the whole revolution began. You say revolution, rebellious movement began. That's where I understood, okay, that's why these people allow their Afro grow, these black folks in America, these weird black Africans. And then I understood the whole thing, you know. I went back, read more about Africans in America, you know, educated myself more about the black movement here in America. I mean, it's not like I wasn't conscious of what was happening in my surroundings. I grew up in a very hostile area. Wari is the biggest, the major oil producing city of Nigeria. We had a lot of conflict, plight. You have companies like Shell operating in the Niger Delta, in that area. A lot of tribalism, you know, war between tribes because of land and oil. So all that I was aware of as a child, but I never... It's almost like you know what is going on and you cannot speak, because you are raised to respect elders, respect the system, respect the community in fear. Fear is interpreted, better to say, respect is misinterpreted and turns into fear.
Time is gone for you to see that love is something else that we practice it to be. The line is long for you and me. That leads us to the very depth of our guts. We're still on the surface deceiving ourselves, but inside we hate and want to see our best friend fall. So let us make a change. Why can't we turn this page? Don't make a saber without you.
You have to be very passionate about what you're doing to stress those issues. And you have to live what you're saying, what you're preaching. If not, it would not have an effect. I believe. I personally believe. You have to understand also that there's a certain risk, especially if you are active in places like Nigeria. I've performed before in Port Harcourt, where I have had I had issues with the government, as well as the secret service, you know. But you know, all these things, I in that very moment you fear, and then you remember, hey Nneka, you're doing what you're doing because you're passionate about it and it concerns you and it is real, you know. But did you forget that you could actually take it to this level and it could lead into something that would be actually dangerous for you and your band members and maybe even other people, you know? But you have to be aware of that and sacrifice that, you know. But who am I, you know? I'm just I also need to remind myself, hey man, come on man, if not you, it's somebody else that will say it, you know. So it's not about me. I'm just a transmitter or transmitter. Most of the time I write and then eventually I find a melody on the guitar or maybe in a beat, in an instrumental. What runs through my mind is, I try not to be too rational about music, you know. I wouldn't sit there and say I have to talk about corruption now and I have to write a first verse and now a second verse and it has to be like this and like that. or it has to suit the record company or suit the masses or what is in. If I feel, you know, if I'm triggered to, it's very rare, you know, very rare that feeling comes over me. It comes, and when it comes, it's strong. It's strong, and then I write, and then it's over. It's like 5 minute thing. Ding dong. It's weird. Yeah. Important is expression. We were raised not to look our parents in the face. I was not able to look at my father in his face until the age of 25. I called my father sir, and I asked him for everything, even if I want to go on toilet. So this fear, that is one thing that I think we need to work on, you know? Fear, respect. What is the definition of that? And how do we now, as young adults, how do we change the way, you know, that we change that mentality, and how do we raise our own kids? Okay, education, very important. Self-expression, what you want to be, what you like, what you think. You know, it's very important that you kids are given that space to express themselves. I have a foundation, a small foundation called Rope, and what we do is to do workshops with children less privileged. What we do, we use music, arts, poetry, paintings, photography, etc., etc., as a platform for these children to express themselves. So it's like a week workshop. They're given that space, that freedom, the happiness to express themselves. And I think that is very important for growth mentally and for your confidence, you know? Many people are not confident, especially women in Africa, you know? There's this, how do you call it? There's a word.
Low self-esteem,
suppression of the mind, mental. Do you say stagnation? I don't know, just stagnant. You're just there, boom, like an anchor. That's a good one. What do you think it is? What do you think my legacy is?
Oh, boy. I know what it is, but I want to hear it from you.
Maybe I don't know what it is. Maybe I'm just doing. You know, maybe I'm just feeling. Maybe I just live for the day and try. And just try and give everything. You know. Just give everything. Positive. Every day. Until Olodumare says Odaro or Bi Odabo. You know. Love. Love, that's the legacy. Love. Honestly, love. Love.